Hello, everyone. We are at Kunstmuseum Basel, Gegenwart, and today my guest is Latifa Echakhch. Thank you so much, Latifa, for coming. It's a really big pleasure for me. I mean, 8 years ago, you were my mentor, and then now having this conversation, I feel blessed. I'm very happy to see you again. And first of all, how are you? How is it going?
I'm fine. I'm very fine. But I feel like very privileged also, like in a way. But I'm fine. I'm trying to take all the positive possible from our situation, and I feel like in a way like a second youth, you know, also. And I like it, like to have like an extended time to think and to work, and and with this all what we call this uncertainty of time, I feel like if I was like 20 year old, like in the same uncertainty, and I like it.
Maybe I would like to start with a big question, because I like big questions, but also we can dig and change. What do you see? What is happening in the world, Latifa? As you, as not maybe as an artist or as an individual, I don't know, generally, how do you see what's happening in the world?
I think we have... I'll talk like really like my feeling, and I know the situation is difficult, and the change are a little bit like new to handle with, and but the way I feel is something different. I feel like we have a time moment, like a moment in time that we can. We are like forced to live in a different way, forced to slow down everything and to stop a lot of things too. And in my point of view, it's not too different from the way I live in general. Because I'm always trying to be like to live in a, like to position myself like one step in the side, to wait and to feel like everything is stopped in a way. It's my really my posture as an artist, and I feel it interesting that like people can experiment this suspension of time, and the fact that people also have maybe a different look or a different point of view in the society, and it's exactly why it's also precious now that a lot of matter. Political matter, gender matter, all the thing that was not taken in charge before, we do it now. So I feel that it's a very lucky time to do that, very necessary, but also very lucky. And I hope we will move the thing in the maximum to be able to be ready for a new world in a way when everything will be better.
And is being an artist, does it bring a bigger responsibility?
I don't know if it's the same responsibility that people can understand, but my responsibility is to have my eyes very open all the time, and to be able also to leave my feeling passing by my cerebral analysis. And this is my responsibility. It's like to do not hide myself from what I see, and to do not hide myself from what I feel, and to be able to be clear enough and sincere enough to give it back to the people or to the audience. So this is my responsibility. My responsibility is only to have like a view on the world around me. It's not the same responsibility as a politician or as people that are like working on the on a direct action for people, but it's my responsibility. So, but I do not have to be ashamed of that. I really assume that that I my only responsibility is to see and to mm-hmm. give back.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Do you think being an artist, when you're an artist, do you think you become automatically a world citizen? Or, I don't know, I feel like that, because when you have open eyes, when you observe everything globally, mm-hmm. you become also global, or is it wrong, or is it only something that I mm-hmm. feel, or how do you feel when you hear the world citizen?
Yeah, it's something that I remember when I was like super young and I involved mm-hmm. myself into art studies, people thought that yes, an artist is always in the margin of the society. Mm-hmm. And I understand very like fastly like that in fact we are not in the margin, like we mm-hmm. are like in the center mm-hmm. of the society. Mm-hmm. And the way I feel like maybe what you said, it's just that I also learn in a way that is not an easy thing, but I learn to be in the center mean I have to assume and to maybe be a little more present, but it doesn't mean that to have my ego or my personality like in the center of everything. Mm-hmm. But the thing is, when I have a perception of things, it's my perception, mm-hmm. but there is nothing like super anormal, mm-hmm. or I'm not a genius of vision, mm-hmm. and I'm not exceptional. The way I feel is the same that a lot of people feel, mm-hmm. because I have to be aware of that. Mm-hmm. It means that I'm absolutely not exceptional. So maybe the thing about like to be like world mm-hmm. Wide to everybody, but it's more about that. Like it's my feeling is part of a global feeling.
Yeah.
And I have a duty of that. Mm-hmm. On the responsibility. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And how is your relationship with politics, generally? In your work, obviously, mm-hmm. we can see these political effects our thinking mm-hmm. very well. I mean, mm-hmm. I see it, mm-hmm. and I believe that everybody is mm-hmm. seeing it. Mm-hmm. But how is your general personal relationship with the politics?
I had during my all these many years since I decided to involve myself as an artist, I had many way of I did many steps about what to understand about my political gesture. Mm-hmm. First, I have to assume that when you have to speak to somebody and to address something to somebody else, it's political.
Yeah.
So whatever you say, it's always political. Mm-hmm. Even if I speak about beauty or flowers mm-hmm. or love, mm-hmm. it's political.
Exactly.
And so that's, for me, there is no question about that. Mm-hmm. And but then after, it's more how to be the more and more open mm-hmm. and to understand that political is the more and more mm-hmm. involved everywhere mm-hmm. and how to have like a clever way or a sensitive way to share it mm-hmm. and to finally make people saying, oh, I feel the same mm-hmm. or I feel the same unbalanced comfort mm-hmm. or I feel the same contradiction of feeling mm-hmm. and that's a political mm-hmm. in a way, but I do not have like a clear message on things mm-hmm. and my political work in a way is just to say that mm-hmm. it's more complex than that mm-hmm. and there is not only one way, and only the fact that you have two poles
yes or no
situation. Yes or no, or it's good or bad,
yeah.
this is not like that. Like yeah. It's good, but it's bad. Mm-hmm. It's bad, but it's good. Or it's sad, but it's beautiful. Or mm-hmm. it's joyful, but it's terribly heavy. Mm-hmm. And there is always this amplitude of mm-hmm. feeling that are big. And I like to give that, like I say, see, it's not easy. Mm-hmm. It's not simple. But the complexity is very rich, and it's in the complexity and the complexity of question that we can have, that we can do and act or share a more constructive political mm-hmm. playground in a way. Mm-hmm.
Latifa, you are a very successful artist, worldwide known. Does it bring a bigger responsibility or something? Or do you feel sometimes like you have to double think or two times, three times think what you are saying before? Can you be just spontaneous?
It's a difficult question.
Yeah.
I would love to say, no, it's changed nothing and yeah. I'm still the same. Yeah. And but it's true that I have, when you have a voice, mm-hmm. you suddenly become like something that have that are public in a way, mm-hmm. so you have to be more not more responsible, because I am a responsible mm-hmm. person, but you have to know what you give and what you do not give, mm-hmm. what you hide and what mm-hmm. you give, mm-hmm. and that's the thing I learned with this idea of success in a mm-hmm. way, but I also, it's really preserved me mm-hmm. and to stay spontaneous and to be spontaneous. But it's true that the spontaneity, mm-hmm. it's always mm-hmm. In a other level. But I am vigilant about that. I'm really taking care of mm-hmm. staying naive.
Yeah.
As you
yeah,
say,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
in the exactly. oriental way.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Exactly. And how do you see the art world of today?
It's
because I wonder, because we were also talking about this before the shooting with Vital, with our cameraman, that we observe that my generation, very young artists, we feel a lot of this feeling of competition. This system, it's all about prize winning, or I don't know, like mm-hmm. everybody's calculating, I should get this gallery, I have to have an exhibition over there. People of mm-hmm. my generation, people at the school, we, instead of talking about art, maybe we started to talk much more about careers, mm-hmm. and I find it very problematic. Do you see what I see?
I see it, but I was luckily raised in an art school where mm-hmm. they told us in the beginning that mm-hmm. maybe nobody of you will become yeah. an artist. So
honest.
For me, it was like, okay, yeah. so it's not the matter. Mm-hmm. And but the thing is that it's true that I saw it going arriving fastly, mm-hmm. and but. It's a situation in a way. It was like that 10 years ago. It was like that also 20 years ago. It was mm-hmm. like that in the 80s, maybe mm-hmm. in the 70s, maybe mm-hmm. with less people, but mm-hmm. it was mm-hmm. in a way. And it was like that 300 years ago. Mm-hmm. yeah. And this idea of competition, we cannot like avoid it in a way, but we also have to understand that it's just a part of the mechanism mm-hmm. and it's just a mechanism, mm-hmm. but it's not the main goal. Mm-hmm. You can be clever in your career and mm-hmm. And producing bad work. Mm-hmm. mm-hmm. And you yeah. can be like very involved in mm-hmm. a public aspect, and inside your studio, it's not. Dance enough. So I think that carries something, and the durability of the artwork is, or the art practice is something else. Yep. So the goal, it's the thing I think when I teach, for example, mm-hmm. and you know mm-hmm. that, I always say that my goal is to just to help you to learn your own process, mm-hmm. just to set things that will make you be able to work mm-hmm. in still mm-hmm. in 30 years and to be still sincere and fresh mm-hmm. and radical. Mm-hmm. And the thing I always say is that the main danger is the problem of recognition. Mm-hmm. So it means that you have to, sometimes kids are just wanted to be accepted by mm-hmm. their peer, like mm-hmm. their own in the art field. And the other is the question of the power. Mm-hmm. Like having more and more success make you give like power, and no, it's not true.
Power, yeah.
And the other is, the third and last problem is the money. Mm-hmm. So people want to have like a career, be sell in galleries and museum or private collectors, everything, but it's not the goal, mm-hmm. because the recognition can be your main enemy. Mm-hmm. The power,
yeah.
Vision could be your worst enemy. Mm-hmm. And the money can be your worst enemy mm-hmm. too. So the thing that we have to learn is to identify this free fragility mm-hmm. of the something that mm-hmm. very human, we all mm-hmm. like mm-hmm. tend to do that and to be okay with that, but it's they are like the main enemies. Mm-hmm. And we have to be like a light with that and think that we have to understand them, mm-hmm. but they are not in the center of our practice. Mm-hmm. Because if you still in 20 years with no money, no recognition, mm-hmm. it's still super okay, mm-hmm. really. Mm-hmm. And I always say that, yeah, my goal is like to be like 80 years mm-hmm. and still like working on things and feeling in the same way mm-hmm. and to be like enthusiastic and to be furious again and yeah. to feel all that, even if nobody knows.
Mm-hmm. It's much more what you are describing. It's much more focusing on what's the resource than the being affected by the outside in your artistic creation practice.
Yeah, it's the expectation, how yeah. you mm-hmm. do with the expectation around you.
Yeah.
And if you want to be integrated on something or not, mm-hmm. and if you want to be accepted or not, mm-hmm. and if you feel that you are to go in that way, it means that you can compromise your work. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And you have to be clever to understand mm-hmm. all this trick, but you also mm-hmm. have to be to feel that you can, mm-hmm. you can, you know, clap on the door.
Exactly.
You can close the door and say that is not, this is not the main things. It's not for that that I signed in the beginning of mm-hmm. my involvement as an artist.
Did you clap a door before?
Yeah, I did it sometime, and people who know me and work with me know, mm-hmm. know that I can do it.
Yeah.
And you know, I feel good, like, yeah. I feel really, really free.
Yeah. Yeah.
And and that it's more, mm-hmm. it's the most important.
And also believing in your faith also, to yes. the trusting into your art, no?
Yes. Yeah. I put like art, like more, art is more important than myself. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Like art is more important than my career, mm-hmm, or mm-hmm. art is more important than just to have money and survive. Mm-hmm. So I did many work, many jobs when yeah. I was younger and everything, and it's okay. I don't need to have like a social recognition of that.
Yeah.
The society do not have a debt on me because just I decided to open my eyes one time. Mm-hmm. They can say, we don't need you. And I can say, okay, me too. Mm-hmm. And but I still see things, mm-hmm. I still feel. Mm-hmm. And you know what I can, if it doesn't happen, mm-hmm. if the career crashed down, yeah. if the career never happened, mm-hmm. what it means that yeah. this faith on arts is compromised? Mm-hmm. I don't feel so. Mm-hmm.
And when you have the art as your main thing, Is it difficult to have a relationship? Like a love relationship or a partner in life, no? I find it like that because what you say, like putting art as the main thing of your life, I really do live like this. And it is very difficult to find also a partner in your life who will understand and respect that, no? And because this partner will never be the priority, number one. Or maybe I have lack of experience.
Now me, I have a fragmentation in my life. So I have like many things. I have kids, you know, and I have a love life. I have friends. I have, I'm a civilian in a way. And it's not that everything have to be with me all the time, like 100%. It's, I switch to one to the other, and but the art is it's more like a motor. It's like a contract. It's something that I know that from with art I can learn more and more. With art I can understand things that I just have the intuition. But if I work more, I can go more far in a way. And I'm learning a lot of things from that. So this art involvement, in a way, it's something that will make my life better, more rich, more like there is like many dimensions that I had like no conscious of that when I was a kid. And I feel really blessed by that in a way. So the fact that I have to work for that is just because there is a job that have to be done. So if the question is going there, I have to follow them. So I cannot just stay on the side and saying okay, not the time. And it's really like a motor. And people who love me have to understand that it's necessary.
And I would like to a little bit talk about this feeling of being foreigner. You and I, we come from outside to Switzerland. Do you, first of all, maybe, do you feel like home here in Switzerland? How was your relationship, the feeling of belonging? Do you feel belong like Switzerland? That was also one of my question of thinking, being global, worldwide citizen. That's,
I born in Morocco. I was raised in France. This immigration at that moment was chosen by my parents for economical reason. And then after like many years, I decide by chance like that, by people I met also, and some friend from Paris moved to Zurich and everything. So, and I was thinking when I was like 32 years old, like I thought that maybe I have to found my own country of immigration. I have to choose one place. But it was at that moment a very funny thing because I wanted so much to learn piano, but to learn piano I had to have a piano. And for to having a piano, I have to have an apartment. And to have an apartment, I have to choose a city and the country then.
Exactly.
And it was a friend artist who showed me that complexity of thing. And he told me this sentence is like to learn piano, you have to found a country. And so then I started to think where. And things bring me to Switzerland, and because I always thought that I can work everywhere. I don't need to be in to be in Morocco or to be in front of my immigration all the time. But in Switzerland, I found these things that were like interesting in a way. You know, like here in the village, in the villages, when you live in a city and you are not born in the city, you are foreigner.
Yeah.
You know that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I say, wow, so I just a foreigner like almost everybody here. And I feel it a little in a way more comfortable. Mm-hmm. And also I like Switzerland also because a lot of people came there like for very different reasons. Mm-hmm. And it was, I always saw it as a land of people passing by. Mm-hmm. And also a lot of artists like just like finish their life in Switzerland. Yeah. And I thought this is particular in a way. So I will just be like another artist like finishing her life in Switzerland. But I know that I am a foreigner. Mm-hmm. And if I forget it sometime, people reminded me.
Yeah.
And especially, yeah, especially 3 years ago, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I told you about this story. Mm-hmm. Once I received a paper saying that you are not anymore with the father of your kids, mm-hmm. you have to leave the country. Yeah. And that was shocking in a way.
I say,
come on, I have a house, I have mm-hmm. like two assistants, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I have two kids, Swiss kids, and yeah. And people say that
I have to leave the country.
And so for 1 month, I was like very stressed. And for 1 month, I was feeling the fragility of my situation. Mm-hmm. And finally, it ended very well. Mm-hmm. Like, they give me the paper mm-hmm. still. And they give me the permissés, so mm-hmm. I was like able to stay quiet mm-hmm. like mm-hmm. for 5 years still, so I'm happy. And 3 months after, I had a tax form.
Yeah.
Like tax form, like we call it control fiscal.
Yes.
Tax control. Yeah. And then they say, oh, okay, I have to stay, but. And it's something that I say, okay, but you have to pay taxes, like, but before you get your paper, before, mm-hmm. because for me to get my paper here was very long. Mm-hmm. So, and so I say, okay, if it's the price to pay, so it's fine, like it's okay. So when I had that, and then like 2 months after, I had this invitation to apply for the Swiss mm-hmm. Pavilion for the Biennale. Mm-hmm. So I thought, you know, in a few months, everything was exactly completely zigzag. We want you, but pay more or less. But we really welcome you. But it's you have to know it's three different like offices.
Yes.
One is immigration, one is taxes, the other is culture.
Yeah.
They are not connecting each other. Yeah, so yeah, I hope it will be very suspicious. But it was. I thought that's life. That's my life. In a way,
yeah.
But I'm happy to be there, but to be here, and but also even if I think of it, but not too much because it will become too heavy, mm-hmm. but I know that it's a good sign mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. to have a immigrant mm-hmm. artists representing mm-hmm. Switzerland for course.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I know that I work for my heart, mm-hmm. my team, mm-hmm. but I also, it mm-hmm. represents something for the others.
Exactly.
That way, my situation.
Exactly.
So on that, I really think that it will be an encouragement mm-hmm. in a way. And I remember when I saw you in your exhibition at Wild, last year, mm-hmm. you were told me about your preoccupation, like your problems, and I say, in a few months, I cannot say, but maybe if everything will be okay, mm-hmm.
I will
give a sign that will help in a way,
yes.
that problem of immigrant artists in Switzerland.
Exactly, and I was so happy to see when the news came out. I was extremely, extremely happy because we need this. Because this is a very, I consider this is my opinion, but it's a very conservative country. Mm-hmm. And the best way to push the boundaries is with mm-hmm. the culture. Mm-hmm. And the one of the best vitrine or stage mm-hmm. for this is the Venice Biennale. Mm-hmm. And I'm so proud of you. I'm so happy for the committee that they selected you. I want to talk about this a little bit from the different perspective. Do you feel offended when you see these extreme right wings posters in the streets? And how do you talk about these things with your children, for example? Because we are not able to vote, but at the same time, we are the target of the votations most of the time. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And how do you feel being this target, being part of this target? Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a problem with... It's a positive thing and a negative thing about this votation. Mm-hmm. It's a popular votation. Mm-hmm. So I try to do nothing too much about the bad mm-hmm. aspect of that, but I'm just wish a lot, very deeply, that we can have like other votation about other subjects mm-hmm. that could be like much more positive. Mm-hmm. And I wish to have like more votation about the equality, the yeah. gender equality. Mm-hmm. I wish to have a votation about how the insurance mm-hmm. are problematic in Switzerland
yeah.
for people who get sick one time in their life mm-hmm. and they do not have anything after. I want to see more this kind of votation there, and I'm a little yeah. bit furious, not about the right-wing votation. Mm-hmm. They try it, mm-hmm. they did it, like mm-hmm. they have the freedom to do it, they do it. Mm-hmm. But I have a problem like to do not see like much more
yeah.
positive votation, and if we leave them taking mm-hmm. the field of popular votation, they will take it. So more progressist politicians have to take their place.
Exactly.
And they have to act. If mm-hmm. they do not do, mm-hmm. they will leave mm-hmm. the place to the others.
Do you think, do we have responsibility as artists in this section? No. Mm-hmm.
What?
We can just talk about that. It's already something.
Even do not talk.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
I don't... You know, it's something I learn. I cannot, you know, just say, oh, you know, I'm kind, I'm not mm-hmm. bad. Mm-hmm. I'm an Arabic woman, mm-hmm. but I'm not an integrist. Mm-hmm. You know, mm-hmm. I cannot act like that all my life to be like the advertising of the good people like me. Mm-hmm. You know, mm-hmm. it's not my rule, like it's yeah. not my posture. I cannot talk about that. Mm-hmm. I just knowing that when I have a page in a newspaper talking about my heart and my practice, people will see it. Mm-hmm. Maybe it will change a little, but it will be more normalized slowly. Mm-hmm. And but I if I do that, the problem in my situation is that I am a public character of the culture field in Switzerland, so I'm already like exceptional. Mm-hmm. The thing is that when you are exceptional, when you are considered like exceptional, mm-hmm. You cannot be an example mm-hmm. because you are a contre-example. Mm-hmm. Oh yes, you have like super nice people like you. We want to have more people like mm-hmm. you from mm-hmm. abroad, but not the other.
Yeah.
So it means that if you start to open your mouth too much, mm-hmm. it will be always acting in the opposite way.
Okay.
And I experiment that in my life. Mm-hmm. Yes, but not you, you mm-hmm. say, because yeah, they yeah, do not yeah. consider me like the other.
Yeah, yeah.
You see?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I am a foreigner, but
that's a very good
I am
point,
a super
actually.
Foreigner, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You are the exceptional.
Exactly.
This is a very important point.
Yeah.
Very important. I didn't think about that yeah. so far. Yeah.
Because I found myself like that, people saying to me,
mm-hmm.
yes, but you are like us.
Yeah, I hear that a lot. Yes. I mean, oh, you're not like other Turkish people that we know. I mean, people, they expect, I guess, that I work in a kebab shop or something, you know?
And that's what I told you before about the fact that artists are not exceptional. For me, in my point of view, as not acting like an exceptional like viewer of things, but it's the same things. Like, I am not an exceptional foreigner. I am, you know, I'm not an exceptional human that feel more than the other. It's just my function in a way. But and you see, it's this kind of thing that are more complex that than what we think. If it could be that, you know, there is so many good foreigners, well, like people are like so, I don't have problem with that still in Switzerland.
It's about a question of visibility also. I mean, these other foreigners, how much they have visibility, how much voice they have. I don't think they have a proper voice at the same time. But we have, now, like now, for example. I don't know. I have to think about this. It's a very important topic. Okay, let's come back to the subject of the biennial. Does it is it a big stress?
It's a big responsibility.
Big responsibility.
For true, yeah, for true. But I cannot, you know, like be with my responsibility like that. Like, you know, it would be like very embarrassing to have that in my shoulder all the time. But I do not forget that. But my main thing is like to this project with I developed with my team with Francesco Stocchi and Alexandre Babel. And I am serving it, like we are working like to have it really built until we can show it to the public. And so this is my main focus. Because I cannot think about all the level all the time. And if I think too much, it will block my practice.
Of course. And do you think this pandemic situation will change in the concept of biennials? Not only Venice, but generally all these movements, big movements. Every month somewhere there is a fair, there is a the biennial or something, an exhibition.
I have like many friends of on many people they are around me that first thing that it was necessary to slow down and to think about where we were going and in which speed. And but we are also a lot like thinking that we miss it so much. You know, when you close all the show and all the we are like just missing art. You know, I'm happy to see exhibition and I'm happy to learn through art. It's not only like a tourist thing, it's just a part of my, I'm missing that. So if you close that, I have like the real life to, I have a lot of things to see in the real life, but I don't know if it will change or not. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know if, but if it's more longer, and if they will have a new consideration of the capacities, the numbers, ideas of opening, the idea of a calendar have to be changed a little bit, but I think it will be complex to reorganize all that, but it's a little price to pay just to make possible like exhibition to be shown everywhere like it was in a way. We cannot stop it. Like we cannot like reduce the exhibition. We have many artists, we have many public, and we still have things to say, to exchange, to feel and to share, but maybe in other forma, or maybe just a question of calendar. Like we do, maybe won't do all these big tours, like one biennial after the other, after the fair, after the. But I don't know. But for sure we miss it all. We all miss it, because it's not only about sharing information. We are, seeing a sculpture is physical, and that we cannot remove it and change it with a Zoom meeting. I cannot have a Zoom meeting with this balloon.
Exactly.
Okay, I can figure out, like in my mind, but I like to see this,
the texture, the form, the shadow,
the smell, the everything. Yeah. I like it, like the reflection of the pink in the floor. Yeah. I like that. That it cannot, like a Zoom meeting will never,
of course,
will never replace it.
Maybe one thing that I'm curious to know how it will also maybe explain how you are working. For example, my feelings are changing. If something is postponing my project, or my feelings for the project or my ideas, they are changing all the time. And now with the postpone, do you keep the project as it is, or it is also transforming with you? Because you are not the same person of last year.
The project stayed the same.
Yeah.
Exactly the same.
Yeah. Is it a choice?
No, it's just because I thought when everything arrived, but not only the pandemic, a lot of things arrived before, since we present our project. But I like the fact to think that could my work resist to everything? And especially my work. My work is always, you know, to have a step in the side, and so it's perfect in this situation. So it's work. It's still needed in the same way I planned it in the beginning. The only thing that changed is that I have 1 year more to live with the project. I have 1 year more to understand better my intuitions and to go, because most of the time, you know, it's true that we do not have too much time. We do never have like 2 years to develop a project, but sometimes we just have like 6 months. But if you extend it to 1 year or 2 years, suddenly you have more time to learn about what you are doing. Because before I was like trying to feel my intuition, my vision, my images that I have, the landscape that I was building, and then I see that if it's that, found the balance and everything, and then I produce the exhibition. And then when I install it, I always like so happy when there is like nobody in the in the art center or the museum, and then I see the work, and it's really a nice meeting. It's really me and my work, and it's the only moment when I feel like that. I say, okay, so that's my work. Hello, that's me. I made you, but you will learn me why I made you. And I have this kind of thing. But when you have like that, like 1 year more, I have more time to learn before it's installed. And it's a luxury.
It's precious.
It's super precious. You know, I feel so lucky. And I feel ashamed to say that, but I feel lucky with the situation.
It's just perfect. Because of that. I mean, it's. And I'm happy to hear it.
Yeah, but it's because I did not have this moment since I was like a student. You know, you have time because you out of the school. You have like no studio, no grant. And you don't know where to start, for what, where, and you have at that moment to settle everything on your practice. It's all the basis of your future work on everything. Everything is settled at that moment. And you have a very, this intense moment is so intense because you do not have all the help from the other. So it's really like it's work or it will never work.
Yeah.
But you know, I trust you, my work, and this is that. And here, because of the slowing down of everything, it's this moment when I am just with the thing I set, with the project I set, and it just just you and me, and I am settling everything. And this is precious. Before it was too fast. I do not have to say, oh, hello. I was like,
Does it come with experience, this trust to your work?
It's come with experience. With experience, you will just forget a little bit about yourself. And you will forget a little bit about the ego thing, this thing that you need some encouragement sometimes. With experience, you won't need that anymore. And that means that it will be more direct. And maybe when I was younger, I was still too much involved as my ego in my work. And now really less, really, really less. And I have much more freedom. I have much more pleasure also. I have much more fun and much more density and gravity also. I feel that without putting myself in the middle of that, you know? It's much more clear.
And Latifa, what would you tell to, I mean, it's gonna be a key, maybe comic question, but what would you tell to 10 years ago's Latifa or young, you know, after school Latifa from now? Because it's a big achievement now, right now. Maybe it's also this having the time. It's also maybe the moment to looking back. And what would you say to just graduated Latifa?
As a just graduated Latifa, I think I know that like the same, like you know what you have to do and stop. making too much tour around, like just go. And the other thing is the thing I know at that moment, because one deep friend of me told me that if things will never happen, it's okay. Do not wait that. And especially my friend Dininster, and he's based in Paris, and he's from New Zealand. Art critic, not an art critic, a thinker, and he told me when I was like 25 years old, I was like in my last year in Sergi, and he say, when you will start to think that maybe you will never be an artist, at that moment you will become an artist, and it's that I know that when I was 25 year old. So that's why I was like never afraid of not getting somewhere or losing anything, because I really understand fastly that it's okay, it's not the goal. That's never changed. But maybe the thing I can say is that just it's normal that you are stressed, it's normal that you are anxious of everything. It's normal that you have like up and down feeling all the time. And it's normal that you have doubt all the time. And it's just a part of the way you work. And it will work. Because maybe when I was younger, I thought that maybe later it will be easier, all that. I will suffer less of my complexity. But now I have more fun about that. I know that maybe just that. Everything will be okay.
Everything will be okay. I think we can say all these things also to everybody who just graduated from the school. Latifa, we have so little time left, and maybe, as the title, Archive of Emotions, do you have anything to say that we should put this in this archive? It can be about the book, or about the topics that we are talking, or again to Latifa, or you know, anything that you would like to archive in this video, or a message, or a change, a wish, something to someone?
And it will be seen like later?
Yeah.
Yeah, so because I feel confident with you and we know each other.
Yeah.
Okay, just say something that everything I learn, I know it's from since my childhood, I think. Maybe it was like difficult to be clear about that and to understand the things. So so maybe I will just, thanks my kids to make me learn that how is humanity is building from the beginning, all this complexity, these things that, and I had the chance to saw it since like 8 years now, and I learned so much from that, and also I learned that like that nothing changed since I was 8 years old, maybe.
Yeah.
Since I was kid, nothing changed. And okay. This is maybe the only archive I want to say.
Yeah.
Only secret.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Latifa, for coming. Yes,
thank you,
it was a very big pleasure.
Thank you, Dorian.
Yeah. Thank you so much for watching us, and see you next week. Bye.